welcome to the Freshwater Senior Campus 2020 graduation. My name is Sarah and this is Angus. We are the 2021 school captains and will be your MCs for today. Firstly, we would like to acknowledge that this ceremony is being held on the traditional custodians of this land's land, the elders of past and present. It is their beautiful spirit and love of community and country that we at Freshwater Senior Campus uphold as we walk and live on this country.
Thank you. Now I would like to ask if you could please stand and take part in the national anthem, which will be performed by Maddie Rabach. Good morning, teachers, graduating students, and families. Whilst today may not look like our previous ceremonies, with all our families and loved ones watching from home, today is still a celebration, a recognition of the efforts and achievements of the graduating class of 2020. We would like to congratulate Year 12 on the completion of 13 years of schooling, and in particular, their final 2 years here at Freshwater. Sarah and I are at the beginning of our journey of the HSC year, and we look to you for inspiration and guidance. Your year group has had more challenges than any other. COVID has interrupted your lives, your study, and even the way you celebrate and come together at this time of year. But through this, you've still worked hard, remained focused, and have achieved huge successes across all facets of the school and community. And today, we will recognise and celebrate your achievements.
On behalf of Year 11, we would like to wish you the very best of luck for your exams and your life beyond Freshwater. We would like to thank you for the example you have set for us, the way you've been resilient and determined. We will try to emulate your success, collaborative effort, and fighting spirit. You're an academically strong group with many talented artists, performers, and designers. We are equally impressed by you and intimidated. Good luck and congratulations. I would now like to invite Mr. Mortimer, the Year 12 Deputy Principal, to the stage to begin the ceremony.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome. Year 12, how good does it feel to be sitting here today at the end of your school journey? Smile at me if you feel good. Good. I'm seeing lots and lots of smiles, so really, really well done. As I have said many times before, I am very proud of you all, and I'm delighted to have been able to have worked with you throughout 2019 and 20, and shall dearly, dearly miss your presence, your good energy and your sparkle. Not long after you started at Freshwater in 2019, so many teachers approached me saying words along the lines of, "Aren't they a nice group of kids?" And I'm certain they will do well. But kids, you are not anymore. 2020 has been a unique year, we all know that. Whilst not wanting to get into the challenges presented too much, because for some it has caused stress, anxiety and fatigue. This is serious, but I have chosen to think back to the good moments, and there needs to be some pandemic reference as it has been a focal point of 2020. So in terms of lock up and talking faces on computer screens, Here is what I think it may have well become.
Sheldon, are you going to join us?
Coming. Greetings, friends.
Greetings, whatever the hell you are.
I am a mobile virtual presence device. Recent events have demonstrated to me that my body is too fragile to endure the vicissitudes of the world. Until such time as I am able to transfer my consciousness, I shall remain in a secure location and interact with the world in this manner.
Really? That's your question? When did he put a ramp in?
You're in my spot.
I'm glad that made you laugh, because it made me laugh. And I think he captures some of the struggles and challenges, in particular, not getting easy access to his spot. Coming into Freshwater in 2019 as new students must have brought back memories of kindergarten and year seven for many. The new school experience, new shoes, new pencil cases, clothes with factory creases, the odd sticky pen left in by accident, discovered later, neat and tidy with a photo taken earlier that day by your proud parents. The anticipation of that day, parental anxiety and bucket loads of tears in private. Probably worried that you, their dear child or children, were going to get isolated and not strike up new friendships at your new school and get off on the wrong foot. Never any of that at Freshwater. For many of you, coming here meant migrating across with old and familiar friends, but for some it would have been like starting from scratch and going back to ground zero, as I often say. Back to almost being invisible. Hopefully you don't feel like that now, but I do know some people have struggled a little bit over the last few months, particularly with COVID. As a Year 12 student some 33 years ago, my goal and one and only goal, in fact, was to get out of school and never come back. This sentiment lasted a matter of weeks as I realised that music education was the pathway for me in late 1987. Having started university and conservatorium very half-heartedly and filled with trepidation and angst, it turned out to be a brilliant decision and a crucial character-building step for me. Whilst my personal journey through university had many lows and highs, the one thing that got me through was the company that I kept. This helped tremendously, and looking back, was a big factor in my success in graduating. The other key feature was perseverance, and thankfully, I have not lost this attribute. As your deputy, my relationship with you may have been close, distant, or somewhere in between. There is a brilliant quote from Confucius. Life is really simple, but we insist on making it complicated. This is so true when you are dealing with people who struggle with school and discover that many of the problems they face are actually self-inflicted. So don't ever over-engineer things. Keep it simple, be honest, and give every obstacle your best attempt. See humour in situations, don't let adversity win, and find that confidence. Sometimes we fail, but in the words of Barack Obama, the real test is not whether you avoid this failure, because you won't. It's whether you let it harden or shame you into inaction, or whether you learn from it, whether you choose to persevere. So don't be put off, and if things don't work out, don't be defeated. Have a rethink and have another go. Walk away only as a very last resort, but only then move on to something new. Your leaders have been an absolutely amazing group that I've really grown very fond of, and I've enjoyed working very closely with them. Erin Carney has led the team, and they meet weekly or have met weekly to discuss all the comings and the goings within the year, commitments, expectations we have of them, leadership opportunities, etc., etc. The list is quite long. But for those that don't know Erin's actually a first-class pastry chef. She makes damn good cookies, she makes incredible cake, and anything dough-related she's absolutely brilliant at. So she's absolutely wonderful. But you know what, back to the executive, their greatest gift has been their wonderful present, their class, their refinement, and their enthusiasm. They are truly students who are respected and admired, who set a positive tone within the year group, and this I am extremely proud of. So can we please give Erin and the team a very, very generous round of applause. Your wellbeing team, your teacher wellbeing team, has been incredible to work with as well. This group meets every week behind closed blinds, and we discuss all kinds of things, including assembly presentations, supporting individuals, year group assemblies, exams, and other matters concerning Year 12. The team consists of Kathy Moran, Caroline Powell, Nolene Cox, Barbara Leonard, Melissa Penrose, Frank Pickard, plus the year advisors, Miss Bayliss, Mr. Lye, and Mr. Watkinson. I attend these meetings, and they are wonderful meetings, and it's enabled us to really get to know you quite well. Another wonderful team that I just wanted to pay homage to was the front office staff, because they're really amazing, and they are very, very fond of you too. So the front office, they're an amazing team that many of you get to know at Freshie. Parents, they will respond to your phone calls. They're always a point of contact within the school. But for students, they perform a range of functions. They interact with hundreds of you every day, helping and assisting where necessary. And I'm sure you'll agree they are a really, really wonderful team. They are always cheerful, they're always professional, they're always helpful. And despite the abundance of sweetheart, sweeties and darlings, they really do know your names and care about you in times of good and bad. So they're a wonderful team, and I'm glad we're acknowledging them today. And finally, your teachers have been blessed with some wonderful teachers. Your teachers think about you almost all of the time. They care very deeply about each and every one of you, and they really do genuinely want the best for you. Teachers speak to me every day about the performance, behaviour and attitude of individuals, and they really do have high standards. Their great relationships make teaching and learning more achievable, and I believe the most successful ones also get to know you as individuals. They love what they do. They're highly committed and will do whatever they can literally to support you. They too will miss you Year 12, and before you leave, try to say goodbye to and thank as many of them as you can. Please give your teachers, the office staff and the wellbeing team a nice hearty round of applause. Okay, and finally, parents, I know you're watching, you're out there in cyberland, so I'd like to thank you as parents here via the internet for the wonderful guidance and support you have provided to your son or daughter. You got them here with constant love, encouragement, front, middle and rear end support. I know that you will continue to encourage them in their pursuits post-school and be there when needed. Everyone's school journey is different, but if your students was simple and sweet, great for you. If it was filled with difficulty and challenges, let's hope the future brings them added maturity, vision and clarity as they make their way through the world, grow up and flourish as adults. And in the words of Sir Edmund Hillary, life is like mountaineering, never look down. I would like to conclude by wishing all of you all the very best, and that everybody here today deserves their place at this graduation, has achieved their personal best and has high hopes for the future. So well done. Year 12, stay optimistic, and after a very, very challenging and unique 2020, see the light and positivity in every situation. Be cheerful, be humorous and authentic. Look after one another and put others first. Surround yourself with the best people who enhance and challenge you, and have a smashing future. My last big speech in 2019 concluded with some words from the famous John Lennon Christmas song, which I sung at you about 8 months ago. So this must continue the legacy. So today, I'd like to conclude with some words by Bob Marley, the famous reggae musician. Love the life you live. Live the life you love. Thank you. Okay, Principal's Outstanding Academic Awards. It gives me great pleasure to introduce the Principal's Outstanding Academic Awards. These awards are given to Year 12 students who have demonstrated the highest academic rigour across their subjects. The awards recognise and celebrate our top achieving students who have worked consistently throughout the year to obtain the best results in the cohort. They have been motivated and focused on academic excellence and embody the spirit of mastering here at Freshwater. It is my great pleasure to announce the following students who will be presented with the Principal's Outstanding Academic Awards for 2020. Carmen Vortala. Hugh Bryan. Alicia Carruthers. Zach Cooper. Bruna Gomez. Naomi Gonzalez Miyagashima. Georgia Hamilton. Lara Heath. Lulu Kunth. Sarah Mayer. Andrew Meisen. Jade Needham. Kyle Neville. Dylan Pitta. Summer Pitta. Haley Pluck.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Jasmine Price. Rachel Turner. Dane Urban. Louis Valente. Sophie Van Claveren. Callum Watts. Remy Williams. And Megan Zappia. Well done to all those students. And it is with great pleasure that I would now like to introduce our first musical item, Jessica Gudmundsson on the saxophone performing Against All Odds. Thank you.
Thank you for that performance, Jess. We will now move on to the presentation of the special awards that recognise students who have achieved and contributed to the Freshwater and the community in ways that go above and beyond. We have always fostered strong community bonds and seek to support and be supported by our local communities. Normally, we would have a number of special guests from the community to help present the awards. However, as this isn't possible this year, we would like to invite Mr. Mortimer back to the stage to present the special awards.
Thanks. I'd just like to invite Mrs. Stacey Exner to the stage, please. Mrs. Exner is our college principal, to present these awards. Freshwater Community Bank, branch of Bendigo Bank, has been in business since 2002 and is an integral part of the Freshwater and Northern Beaches community. They actively support a wide range of community groups, including sporting, schools, organisations, charities and environmental activities. Their aim is to support local community groups and organisations by providing sponsorships, tertiary scholarships and other support mechanisms. To date, they have provided over $3 million to these community groups. These scholarships are intended to enable students to enter and undertake graduate and undergraduate university degree courses or equivalent. This year, the nominated recipient will be awarded a $2,000 scholarship towards their tertiary studies. After a rigorous process and some outstanding student applications, it gives me great pleasure to announce that this year's recipient for Freshwater is Andrew Meisen. Andrew, come up. Andrew is a most outstanding student who has performed in an exemplary level across all academic subjects, placing in the top 10% of every one of his courses. Andrew has been a dedicated and motivated student who, upon his arrival at Freshwater, realised the academic calibre was challenging. He refused to let this intimidate him, and this gave him the motivation to be his best self. It is this grit and determination that has been seen a very steady and impressive improvement in his results. Not only is Andrew academic, he's also been working towards his goal, Duke of Edinburgh, a program renowned for its challenging and rigorous pursuits. Throughout the program, he has gained important life skills like perseverance and empathy. In addition to this, Andrew is a keen martial artist who has been training in Taekwondo for 13 years and achieving a black belt. The disciplined training of martial arts has instilled in him the qualities of integrity, courtesy and determination. Around the school, Andrew can be found lurking in the library, working hard and achieving the best results he can. He has shown particular interest in the STEM subjects and enjoys problem solving and investigative tasks. Andrew is a collaborative learner who enjoys the group dynamic and is often seen helping other students, working with his peers and being supported by staff. Andrew's most impressive quality is his self-belief and unwavering ambition to realise his educational dreams, as he and his family value the true gift of education. A most worthy recipient. Congratulations, Andrew. The Defence Force's Long Tan Youth Leadership and Teamwork Award. The Defence Force's Long Tan Youth Leadership and Teamwork Award is named after the Battle of Long Tan, which was fought on the 18th of August 1966, where Australian soldiers, despite being vastly outnumbered by the Viet Cong, overcame enormous odds. It is a battle that embodies the values we have as Australians and we have come to recognise: strength, teamwork, courage, friendship and leadership. This award recognises students who demonstrate leadership and teamwork within both the school and the broader community, and who display strong values such as doing one's best, respect for others and mateship, values considered integral to both the ADF and Australian society. A student whose knowledge, appearance and behaviour shows respect for the values of the school and community, and who demonstrates the application of a high standard of values in all facets of life, and whose presence in the team enhances the outcome. The recipient receives a certificate and a $500 scholarship. This year's recipient has been a strong leader across many fields during her time at Freshwater, and has represented the values of the Long Tan Leadership Award at all times. She's an impressive student, and it gives me great pleasure to present the award to Talani Toms. The ADF Future Innovators Award has been designed to recognise recipients' science and mathematics abilities while highlighting the value of the Navy, Army and Air Force place on STEM skills and STEM career opportunities within the defence. These awards are a means to formally recognise those students who have demonstrated their motivation and innovation in areas of STEM within their school and who display strong personal ethical values such as doing one's best. A student who embodies these values, who has worked extremely hard and produced some outstanding results across all of his subjects, but displays particular strength for the STEM subjects, is Dane Urban. Please congratulate Dane. The Outstanding Effort Awards, which is the Adams Award, recognises a student who has worked consistently over the past 2 years despite facing some hardship. This award is donated by the Adams family, whose son attended Freshwater some years ago. This year's winner is a worthy recipient of this award, and as a result of her exceptional growth and personal maturation, as she has navigated some challenging times whilst performing to the best of her ability during the last 2 years. Congratulations to Paige Ronzini. Paige is a worthy recipient of this award as a result of her maturity in accepting and managing academic and personal challenges during the past 2 years. Her motivation and determination were clear from the moment she started at Freshwater Senior Campus. Her accomplishments and the qualities that make Paige outstanding include a strong sense of self, positivity, responsibility, organisational ability, gratefulness, politeness, commitment to learn and resilience. Her ability to reconcile her concerns and pull herself back up when things have not been going well is inspiring. Paige has made the impossible seem possible. She has turned challenges into success and has flourished here at Freshwater. She has perfected the art of gratitude and leaves smiles in her wake. It gives me great pleasure to give the Outstanding Effort Award to Paige Ronzini. Freshwater Best All-Rounder. In 2018, the family of our 2017 sports captain, Amber Moran, donated a prize and trophy to recognise future students who have achieved success and worked to the best of their ability in the areas of academia, personal conduct, leadership, service to school community, sport, and above all, an exemplary attitude. These values align with those of the Caltech's Best All-Rounder, and so we have combined the award and it has become the Freshwater All-Rounder. This year's recipient is a most excellent student who represents Freshwater Senior Campus exceptionally well. Congratulations to Zach Cooper. As a keen and talented sportsman, Zach has been a successful and tenacious rugby league player. His dream is to play for the mighty Manly Sea Eagles. Whilst being committed to this dream, Zach has also been an exemplary student, achieving extremely high academic results across all of his subjects. Zach has worked hard to improve all aspects of his study, demonstrating a quiet determination that has been an inspiration for those around him. Zach has been a leader amongst his peers. Through his outlook and focus, he has led by example and demonstrated that he is a most capable student, talented sportsman and impressive young man. Zach embodies all of the values of a Freshwater All-Rounder and is a most worthy recipient of this award. Congratulations again, Zach. Mastering, Connecting and Flourishing Awards. At Freshwater, we have a merit system that underpins our teaching and learning as it reflects the school's strategic plan. The key strategic directions were decided in 2014 and have remained our key focus. The areas of mastering, connecting and flourishing were designed to reflect the holistic education of our students. We aim for them to master their academic learning, flourish as individuals with a sense of holistic growth and connect to each other, the school and the community beyond. This year, in addition to the gold, silver and bronze awards, we are celebrating our top merit achievers across the three domains. Please congratulate our top mastering student, Zeke Whitfield. Don't go far. Our top flourishing student is Ella Bick. And our top connecting student is again Zeke Whitfield. Outstanding contribution to the creative and performing arts. The Fries family supports the creative and performing arts at Freshwater through the sponsorship of the outstanding contribution to the creative and performing arts. I am pleased to announce this year's recipient is Sam Gaspar. Sam has been an outstanding contributor to all things creative and performing arts. He is a keen and talented drama student, a capable and integral member of the entertainment class, and an avid filmmaker. Sam's contributions go above and beyond. Through Sam's reliable and knowledgeable assistance at most assemblies and formal situations, he has helped to ensure the smooth and professional running of all our Freshwater activities. His creative contributions within the drama class have always been valued, and he is a positive and empathetic student. In addition to this, Sam has been a part of the multimedia crew that have been responsible for many whole school activities and has demonstrated his strength as a filmmaker and team member. Sam has been the embodiment of our school spirit and thoroughly deserves this award. Congratulations again, Sam. Industrial Tech Timber Awards. As with many things this year, our annual Industrial Technology Timber Showcase couldn't happen again as per usual. However, our talented students have still been working extremely hard and producing outstanding design pieces. This year, Britain Timbers has awarded the following students with awards for their individual timber designs. Best overall design and craftsmanship goes to Ollie O'Rourke. And Ollie also receives a $500 cash prize from Carbon Tech. Most creative design, Harry Smith. And Harry also receives a $250 cash prize from Carbon Tech. Congratulations again, Harry. Well done to both those students. Gold Duke of Edinburgh. The Duke of Edinburgh's International Award is available for all 14 to 24-year-olds. Participants are required to complete four sections at level: voluntary service skill, physical recreation, and adventurous journey. Gold level participants also complete a gold residential project. The award comprises three levels, each progressively more challenging: bronze, silver and gold. The Bronze Duke of Edinburgh is a prestigious and challenging award that is internationally recognised. This year we have eight recipients of the gold award. Congratulations to the following students. Megan Gravemaid McKenzie. Samantha Herfnagels. Surname missing. Felicity McKenzie. Isla Oxbrow Shorts. Madeline Rabash. Phoenix Schwartz. Philippa Stoppel. And Ronya Stoppel. Congratulations to all our special award recipients. Could I please now call Ms. Shannon Cooper, our sports coordinator, to come to the stage to present the sports awards.
So sport this year has definitely been somewhat different, with unfortunately a lot of sporting opportunities cancelled. After coming off our most successful sporting year last year, many of you were keen on getting involved and representing the school in your last year. However, COVID did have another plan. We did kick the year off with some of you selected in Sydney North teams. The successful winning of the girls at the Vista High School Challenge and the boys team placing second. Despite the interruptions to sport, I hope you've all had the chance to make some special memories competing here at Freshy in sport in one of our sporting teams or our swimming, cross country or athletics carnival. I do have the pleasure today of announcing that Year 12 2020, the year group that sits before me, are the winners of the Bird for 2020. So congratulations. I'm sure Mr. Mortimer is going to be happy with that. A big thank you must go to the teachers who have coached knockout teams over the last 2 years, because without them, you wouldn't have had the opportunities to be a part of knockout teams. A big thank you to Frank Pickard, Ashley Matheson, Sue Saunders, Sam Trumper, David Watkinson, Yana Salakis, Renee Delaney, and Maren Baylis. If we can all please give them a round of applause. Now for our individual sporting awards. The following students have achieved some amazing results in both teams, individuals, in-school and out-of-school sporting representation. Please note that due to the interruptions to sport this year, award winners were selected off their achievements over 2019 and 2020. Could we please hold the applause until the end of the citation? The first award is the Sports Commitment Award, presented to the student that has made an immense commitment to representing Freshwater in a number of events across a wide range of sporting categories. The recipient this year has put her hand up for almost every sporting opportunity and has constantly demonstrated team spirit and enthusiasm. If I can please call to the stage, Isabella Siebold. Isabella receives the award for a contribution in sport in the following teams: Girls Open Basketball Team 2019-2020, Girls Open Touch Team 2019-2020, Girls Open Netball Team in 2019 and 2020, and the Freshwater Senior Campus Athletics Team. Congratulations, Isabella. The next two students that have been called on stage is for the prestigious Australian Olympic Changemaker Award, previously known as the Pierre de Coubertin Award. This award is an initiative of the Australian Olympic Committee and recognises their sporting achievements and the demonstration of these endeavours consistent with the aims of the Olympic movement. Throughout their representation in their following sporting roles, as well as coaching up-and-coming athletes in the local community, these two students have made an exemplary effort to achieve their personal best and displayed qualities of fair play, which has inspired the involvement of others. Our first recipient is Maddie McGrath for her leadership and achievement in touch football, including the Girls Open Touch Team in 2019 and 2020, Sydney North and New South Wales CHS Touch Team in 2019, Manly Warringah Open Touch Team, the Sydney Scorpions Team in 2019 and 2020, and her selection into the Australian Youth Squad for 2020. Congratulations, Maddie. Our second recipient of this award is Tane Wright for his leadership and achievement in AFL. Unfortunately, there are no school opportunities in AFL after the age of 15. However, Tane's accomplishment outside of school, both coaching and playing, are immense. Tane is a member of the Manly Warringah Wolves division team. He is in the New South Wales Rams under-18s team and has been for 2019 and 2020. And he has been selected and represented in the under-18 Sydney Swans Academy team in 2018, 2019 and 2020. Congratulations, Tane. Most Outstanding Sports Person of the Year. This is awarded to the student, both boy and girl, who have represented and competed at the highest level for their chosen sport whilst completing their HSC schooling at the same time. Due to COVID, the selection process was made a little bit harder this year. However, we received many applications from a number of the talented athletes within Year 12. The two winners have represented Freshwater Senior Campus at a New South Wales level, as well as their outstanding achievements outside of school at a national and international level. The first student I would like to call on stage is our female recipient, Katie Economist, who has received the award for Girls Open Volleyball Team 2019 and 2020, her selection in the Sydney North Girls Volleyball Team for 2019 and 2020, her selection and representation of New South Wales at the Indoor Australian Championships Under 19 team for 2019 and the Under 21 Beach Volleyball Team for 2020, and her representation of Australia in the Indoor Volleyball Under 20s team. Congratulations, Katie. The next student I would like to call on stage is our Mayor recipient, Scott Wong. Scott receives this award for his outstanding achievements in athletics. He has represented Freshwater Senior Campus at the Ringer Zone, Sydney North, CHS and All School Athletics Championships. He has broken the under 16 boys 100 and 200 metre record at the Ringer Zone Athletics in 2019. He is the 100 and 200 metre champion at the 2019 New South Wales Club Championships, and he qualified for the 2020 Australian Junior Championships, unfortunately called off because of COVID. Congratulations, Scott.
Congratulations to all those award recipients. An impressive display of talent. I would now like to invite Alina Wallace to the stage. She will be performing I Have Nothing.
Don't.
Thank you, Eleanor. Could I invite your advisor, Miss Bayliss, to the stage to give her final farewell to Year 12 and begin the presentations to the 2020 graduates?
Good morning, parents, staff, and the graduating class of 2020, Year 12. We are here this morning to celebrate your achievements as 13 years of schooling are nearing the end with the HSC on the horizon. Back in 2002, the year when most of you were born, the most popular names were Emily and Joshua. Another major birth was the second generation iPod. So if your parents were up with the tech, they were listening to Whenever, Wherever by Shakira and Without Me by Eminem. The highest grossing film was The Lord of the Rings, The Fellowship of the Ring, and the year was the year of the horse. The horse symbolises power, beauty, and freedom. And those of you who were born are also high-spirited, active, and energetic. We hope as your teachers that those qualities will flourish as you prepare for and complete the HSC. Year 12, we look forward now to you starting a new chapter of your lives. And since your very first day at kindergarten to this, your last day at school, there have been a number of people who have been your cheerleaders to get you to this point in time. Perhaps the most significant people in this process have been your parents. To our parents who are watching our graduation through the live stream, we want to thank you for your support, your guidance, your encouragement, especially over the last 2 years. Our Year 12 cohort has demonstrated great resilience and grit in what has been a very challenging year. And we know that the development of these positive qualities all begin at home. Year 12, it has been a privilege and an honour to be your other mother for the last 2 years, which has formed many fond memories for all of us. Orientation week, including our days at Long Reef and Luna Park, Bickies with Bayliss in 326, assemblies filled with entertainment from our talented musicians, singers, Monday afternoon study sessions, bin ball challenges, Mufti days for our charities, and lots more. Well done to you all. School is increasingly complex with much bigger demands that I experienced when I did the HSC 35 years ago. One example is I never had to Zoom. Year 12, you are super Zoomers. You have all worked particularly hard to meet the challenges of the HSC. You have applied yourselves to achieve your goals in a wide range of subjects, and many of you have completed major projects in English, art, music, industrial technology, textiles, dance, drama, society and culture, all the while being responsible, motivated and focused. Year 12, use all the skills you have learned so far to equip you well for the journey ahead. And think back to the friendships you have made, the fun times, the special memories and the successes that you have celebrated over the last 13 years. As meaningful relationships are one of life's true gifts. Year 12, we will miss you a lot. You've been a great squad, and as you head forth and tackle the HSC, remember to bend, stretch, and reach for the stars. You have nailed 2020, and we could not be prouder. And finally, I want you all to remember this. If I had a flower for every time you made me laugh and smile, I would have a garden to walk in forever. I would like to now invite Mr. Pickard to the stage to present the graduands A to G. If the audience could hold their applause till the end, but mums and dads at home, knock yourselves out. Carly Adams. Olivia Allenson, Silver Merit Award. Gabriella Andia. Zali Anakin. Bronze Merit Award. Charlotte Asbridge, Bronze Merit Award. Will Avery. Mia Bandera. Denise Banez. Jack Bannister, Bronze Merit Award. Elizabeth Bardsley. Carmen Bartolo, Principals Academic Excellence Award, first in Food Technology, first in Legal Studies, first in Biology, and Bronze Merit Award. Harrison Batten. Emily Batista, Silver Merit Award. Bianca Beck, Bronze Merit Award. Joshua Beasley, Bronze Merit Award. Molly Bell. Pierre Bertozzi. Chanel Black. Talia Black, Bronze Merit Award. Samuel Blair. Ella Blick, Flourishing Award and Gold Merit Award. Angela Brillantes, first in Mathematics Extension 1 and Bronze Merit Award. Alicia Brillantes. Ella Brown. Luke Brown. Mackenzie Brown. Hugh Bryan, Principal's Academic Excellence Award and Silver Merit Award. Noah Bryant. Hannah Buckley, Silver Merit Award. Harriet Burke, first in Society and Culture and Silver Merit Award. Laura Bussey. Gabriella Cardoso, Commitment to Star. Anya Carlin Jorgensen, Silver Merit Award. Tasman Carroll, Gold Merit Award. Alicia Carruthers, Principal's Academic Excellence Award and Silver Merit Award. Ewan Carter. Samuel Casper. Laura Cherry. Angus Chipman, Bronze Merit Award. Kayla Christie. Nathan Clark. Josh Curtsey, Contribution to Creative and Performing Arts Award. Mia Kalella, Commitment to Star, Gold Merit Award. Sophie Collings, Bronze Merit Award. Lucy Collins. Rebecca Collins. Zachariah Cooper Singe. Zach Cooper, First in Geography, Silver Duke of Edinburgh, and Silver Merit Award. Arturo Cox. Kelsey Ann Crawford, Bronze Merit Award. Tian Cronier. Charlotte Cullum, Commitment to Star. Shariah Cummings. Grace Cummins. Harriet Cummins, Gold Merit Award. Kira Darcy, Bronze Merit Award. Hayley Dalton. Alexandra Danilovic. Olivia Davenport, Commitment to Star. Carwin Davies, Silver Merit Award. Jack Davis, Bronze Merit Award. Eleanor Day, Bronze Merit Award. Liam Delaney. Scout Deschamps. Jada DeVisa. Oscar Jewis, First in Entertainment and Silver Merit Award. Jasmine Dixon, Silver Merit Award. Isabella Donahue, Commitment to Star. Michael Donahue. Max Donahoe, Gold Merit Award. Ella Doughty. Billy Drury, Bronze Merit Award. Elise Duffel. Thomas Dunn. Catherine Economist, Sports Person of the Year and Gold Merit Award. Eric Ellery, Bronze Merit Award. Hayley Engelander. Kira Eichelenkamp. Madison Forshon. Sophia Ferguson, Creative and Performing Arts Award and Bronze Merit Award. Will Ferguson. Iona Finlay, Silver Merit Award. Rachel Fox, Bronze Merit Award. Zoe Fraser, Bronze Merit Award. Zalia Fries, Bronze Merit Award. Tina Fu. Emily Fuller.
Congratulations, Tina.
Grace Gabriel.
Well done, Grace. Congratulations.
Leona Gann, Silver Merit Award.
Well done, Leona. Congratulations.
Renee Gaspar. Fraser Geelan.
Well done, Fraser. Congratulations.
Toby Geisker, Silver Merit Award.
Well done, Toby.
Aaron Gearless, Outstanding Commitment to Star. Mia Glasson. Ellen Goff.
Well done,
Bruna Gomez, First in Ancient History and Silver Merit Award.
Well done,
Naomi Gonzalez, Commitment to Star. Brody Gordon, Bronze Merit Award. Clementine Gourlay, Silver Merit Award.
Well done,
Zoe Gowles, Bronze Merit Award. Bella Granger. Megan Gravemaid, Gold Duke of Edinburgh and Bronze Merit Award. Max Grayling. Megan Green. Nicholas Gregory, Bronze Merit Award. Jessica Gudmundson, First in Music One and Silver Merit Award. Thank you very much. Could you please give these students a warm round of applause? I now have the great pleasure of introducing another musical item. Please welcome Sophie Takakis performing Lover, You Should Have Come Over.
As my shoes fill up with water, maybe I'm too young to keep the love from going wrong, but tonight you're on my mind, so you'll never know. Down and hungry for your love, with no way to feed it. Where are you tonight? You know how much I need it. Too young to hold on, and too old. Like it should be, having is fun, but it's too blind to see the damage he's done. Sometimes a man must awake to find the real. Sweet return. Oh, will I ever love?
Thank you, Sophie. As the presentations continue, we'd like to invite your advisor, Mr. Andrew Lai, to the stage to give his farewell and continue the presentations.
Good morning, parents on the live stream. Hopefully the sound is loud and clear. Staff in the graduating class of 2020. I would like to share one final message as you all prepare to embark onto your next stage of life beyond Freshie. Channeling the multimedia and technology teacher in me, I've decided to use an analogy of the charging cable. So I brought a prop with me today, and I just wanted to share three values that will hopefully be taken beyond Freshie. So the first one is adaptability. Just like this charging cable that I have in my hand, it's a 3-in-1 charging cable. It supports Android, supports iPhone, and USB-C. Now, if anything, the year 2020 has definitely taught us all to rapidly adapt, reflect on what truly is important, and to embrace meaningful changes. From Google Classroom, Microsoft Teams, to endless Zoom calls, I think we've all had our fair share of going virtual and adapting to changing circumstances. The world is transforming every minute, and the future is filled with the unknown. But if we can keep an open mindset, I'm sure we'll be able to pivot through whatever it may throw at us. The second value is this: patience. Charging takes time, even with fast charge. When so many things in our world today are pointing us towards instant gratification and an on-demand mindset, it is important that we learn to slow down, especially on the things that matter to us most. Any significant success takes a lot of hard work, energy, and patience, which I'm sure all major project students can attest to. Remember to take your time to explore your interests, and don't feel like you need to have it all figured out. Continue to work on developing your skills, your attitude, and keep on trying. The third and last value is generosity. Don't forget to charge those around you. When others are down or require support, be generous with your time, with your energy, and kindness to build them up. Generosity is doing something for someone else and expecting absolutely nothing in return. This is definitely something that I have witnessed day in and day out at my time here at Freshie, and it is a core component of the Freshie family culture that we have here. We as your advisors are proud of every single one of you and trust that you'll continue to support each other beyond Freshie. Year 12, it's been an absolutely unforgettable 2 years, and we'll all miss you dearly. I wish you all the very best for your future endeavors, and let us continue to be adaptable, patient, and most importantly, generous with your time and energy. Let us all be the charging cable. Congratulations, Year 12. I would now like to invite Mr. Frank Pickard and my year group, H2O, to begin their graduation process. Mary Habshi, Outstanding Commitment to Star Silver Merit Award. Harry Haggart, Contribution to Creative and Performing Arts Award. Talia Hall. Luca Halmagi. Georgia Hamilton, Principals Academic Excellence Award, First in English Standard, Gold Merit Award. Amelia Hancock. Imogen Hanrahan. Ella Harris, Bronze Merit Award. Lauren Harris. William Harrison. Sophia Harv Osberg, Bronze Merit Award. Lara Haygarth, Bronze Merit Award. Lara Heath, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, First in Drama, Gold Merit Award. Gabriella Heffernan, Bronze Merit Award. Caitlin Hickey, Gold Merit Award. Kane Hillier, First in English Extension 1, Bronze Merit Award. Paige Hillier. Maya Hodges, Bronze Merit Award. Samantha Hofnagels, Gold Duke of Edinburgh Award, Bronze Merit Award. Amber Holly. Charlotte Holway, Outstanding Commitment to Star, Bronze Merit Award. Lara Horner. Thomas Howe, Silver Merit Award. Jessica Huckle. Natasha Huckstep, Commitment to Star. Daniel Hume, Bronze Merit Award. Taliesin Hunt, Bronze Merit Award. Finley Hurd, Bronze Merit Award. Hudson Hurt, Silver Merit Award. Alexander Jacobs, Silver Merit Award. Sophia Jansens, Bronze Merit Award. Kira Johnson. Elora Jerluff. Holly Jones, Creative and Performing Arts Award, Gold Merit Award. Harry Kay. Rory Keary. Tom Kennis. Declan King, Bronze Merit Award. Lulu Nuth, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, First in Community and Family Studies, Silver Merit Award. Elliot Kofkin. Natalia Kovacevic. Jessica Cranenberg. Andrew Lan, first in industrial technology multimedia, bronze merit award. And one more thing, charging cable goes to Andrew Lan for doing the graduation video. Olivia Langer. Lucas Lanning. Georgia Larissa. Portia Lachlan. Rhiannon Leatham. Genevieve Leonard, outstanding commitment to STAR. Joshua Lewis. Nina Lewis, first in Japanese. Finn Lilienthal. Jensen Lotz, first in Information Processes and Technology. Mia Luanga, Outstanding Commitment to STAR, Silver Merit Award. Giovanna Losciavo, Bronze Merit Award. Dallas Lowry, Gold Merit Award. Grace Mackey. Felicity McKenzie, Gold Duke of Edinburgh. Sarah Ma, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, first in PDHPE, Silver Merit Award. Kai Major, Bronze Merit Award. Charlie Malivinik, Silver Merit Award. Zena Manger. Helena Manuel, first in Dance, Creative and Performing Arts Award. Sunny Marnie. Angus Marshall, Gold Merit Award. Ben Martin. Jackson Martinez. Bailey Mason. Victoria Mastriani, Bronze Merit Award. Holly Moore. Poppy Mayhew, Gold Merit Award. Tara McCready. Ellie McGilray, Bronze Merit Award. Maddie McGrath, Australian Olympic Change Maker Award, Silver Merit Award. Raphael McGrath. Jesse McGuffug. Well done, Jesse. Naomi McPherson. Kelsey Miles. Mia Miletic, Silver Merit Award. Jonathan Mitchell, First in German Continuous Silver Merit Award. Andrew Mizon, Community Bank Freshwater Branch Tertiary Scholarship Award, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, First in Chemistry, Silver Duke of Edinburgh Gold Merit Award. Mia Moon, Bronze Merit Award. Sky Mordant, Outstanding Commitment to Star Bronze Merit Award. Declan Murray. Liam Natras, Bronze Merit Award. Jade Needham, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, First in French Continuous. Louis Neary. Kyle Neville, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, First in Earth and Environmental Science, Silver Merit Award. Grace Newham, Bronze Merit Award. Matisse Newson. Alexandra Nicole. Lauren O'Brien, Bronze Merit Award. Madeline O'Connell. Jeffrey O'Neill, Bronze Merit Award. Oliver O'Rourke, Britain Timbers for Industrial Technology Timber 2020 Major Projects, Best Overall Design and Craftsmanship, First in Industrial Technology Timber, Bronze Merit Award. Amy O'Toole, Silver Merit Award. Jake Osborne. Monique Ovenden, Bronze Merit Award. Isla Oxborough, Gold Duke of Edinburgh, Bronze Merit Award. And finally, Cameron Oxley. Thank you. Congratulations to all those students. Could we now please welcome Maddie Rabash to the stage for a performance of Everyone Is Waiting.
Expected to play, but in my reflection I am worlds away. As I put my costume on, eyelashes worn by one, I've been doing this so long I can tie the knot. Everyone's waiting.
It's getting harder to hear what my heart is saying, and everyone's waiting. Those painful lessons you've had to learn, you gotta use them now or never. And everyone's waiting. It makes it harder to hear what my heart. Turn it all off. I just want to turn it off. I just want to turn it off. And everyone's waiting. It's getting harder to hear what my heart. Turn it off. I just wanna turn it all off. When everyone's waiting, it makes it harder to hear what my heart is saying. Oh, turn it off. I just wanna turn it all off. When everyone's waiting, and everyone's waiting.
Thanks, Maddie. To complete the presentations and give his farewell, could I please invite Mr. David Watkinson, your advisor, to the stage.
Now that's very funny, there's a ruler here. I don't see many of those in class, but anyway, there you go. Now then, good morning, parents, teachers and class of 2020. So 2 years ago, along with 700s, you applied for Freshie. You got in and came along the first day all nervous, wondering what you'd done. 300 new faces and room numbers that just didn't make sense. You were looking for something different, a new start, some freedom to learn. Pretty quickly, you realised things were a little bit different here. Quiet corridors, no rugrats running around. You told your parents that no one does any work in year 11 and you take things a bit more seriously in year 12. You set yourself some goals and you set about achieving them. First, you discovered coffee and you learned that to be late to class is one thing, but to wander in late holding a soy latte got quite a different reaction. Second, you learned to drive and you sat in terror listening for your rego number whenever the school intercom announced a car was being towed from Brighton Street. Third, you learned about work-life balance. You realised at the end of year 11, even before you'd taken your preliminary exams, that if you dropped line 6, you could pull 48-hour shifts at Macca's to pay for your newfound love of coffee, petrol and your mobile phone plan. To your credit, despite these new distractions, from week 6 each term when the goal sheet started to be delivered, you pulled all-nighters to get those assessment tasks done. Then all of a sudden it stopped. We sent you home. You soon realised, though, you could spend the whole day in your pyjamas eating cereal. You just had to remember to turn your Zoom camera off. We talk a lot about resilience, and this year we all needed some. As teachers, we've all been incredibly impressed by how well you've adapted and coped with the ever-changing normal. In the last few days, we've seen our visual arts and textile students' major works on display, designed projects completed, the multimedia showcase, and our school concert, demonstrating not only the incredible talent we have here, but also the exceptional effort and collaboration between Freshie students and staff that make this school the incredible place that it is. It's been wonderful to see you have fun this week. So today, celebrate. Thank your teachers, hug your friends, and take your parents out for lunch. You owe them one. It's been a 13-year marathon, and now it's just a short sprint to the finish line. Stay focused, and if all else fails, read the question. Finally, as you prepare to leave us and grasp the freedom you've been looking for, I'll leave you with one piece of advice. Always treat people how you would want to be treated yourself, because no one remembers what you do or what you say, but they always remember how you make them feel. Congratulations, Year 12 of 2020. You really are the best year ever. I'll now invite my year group, P to Z, to begin their graduation process. Please save your applause till the end. Thank you. Okay, Alia Pacelli, Bronze Merit Award. Hannah Page, First in Hospitality. Cooper Peak, Commitment to Star and the Bronze Merit Award. Dylan Pittar, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, First English Advanced, Commitment to Star and Gold Merit Award. Summer Pittar, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, First in Modern History, Commitment to Star and Silver Merit Award. Hayley Pluck, Principal's Academics Excellence Award and Gold Merit Award. Sapphire Powley Burnett. Isabel Prandtl, First Mathematics Standards. Jasmine Price, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, Bronze Merit Award. Alana Privett. Florence Pudicombe. Georgia Quinn. Madeleine Rabarch, Gold Duke of Edinburgh, contribution to creative and performing arts. Lucas Ray, Bronze Merit Award. Mitchell Ray, Bronze Merit Award. Courtney Rafferty. Tanya Razboynikov. Isabel Reed. Jack Reed. Bailey Reimer, Silver Merit Award. Jasmine Riggs. Bree Ritchie, Silver Merit Award. Blaise Roberts, Silver Merit Award. Isabel Roberts, First Engineering Studies, Silver Merit Award. Victoria Robinson, Outstanding Commitment to Star, Bronze Merit Award. Lily Roddick, Gold Merit Award. Aaron Rogers, Bronze Merit Award. Paige Ronzini, Outstanding Effort Award and Bronze Merit Award. Ethan Rosnell. Daniel Rowe. Jade Ruskin. Ailey Russell. Darren Sarmiento. Ashley Satchel. Olivia Schultz. Phoenix Schwartz, Gold Duke of Edinburgh Award. Hannah Skopelitis, Bronze Merit Award. Isabella Seabold, Sports Commitment Award and Silver Merit Award. Madok Shamsaria, Bronze Merit Award. Caitlin Shaw. Keisha Sheehan. Ruby Sibray, Gold Merit Award. Joe Slade. Harry Smith, Britain Timbers for Industrial Technology Timber 2020 Major Projects, Most Creative Design. Indika Smith, Silver Merit Award. Maximilian Smith. Tyler Smith. Zoe Smith, Creative and Performing Arts Award, Silver Merit Award. Hugo Staback, Contribution to Creative and Performing Arts Award. Albert Flynn Stouffer, Commitment to Star, Bronze Merit Award. Savannah Stouffer, Bronze Merit Award. Mia Stevens, Bronze Merit Award. Millie Stewart. Michaela Stonell, Commitment to Star, Bronze Merit Award. Philippa Stoppel, Gold Duke of Edinburgh Award and Silver Merit Award. Ronya Stoppel, Gold Duke of Edinburgh Award and Bronze Merit Award. Nina Strange, Bronze Merit Award. Jordan Stubbington. Saskia Stigliano, Silver Merit Award. Lily Sullivan. Charlotte Sun. Hunter Sydenham. Well done, Sophie Takax, Gold Merit Award, Contribution to Creative and Performing Arts. Gabrielle Tate, Bronze Merit Award. Jeremy Tolman. Talali Toombs, Defence Forces Long 10 Leadership Award, Outstanding Commitment to Star and Gold Merit Award. Hannah Toogood, Bronze Merit Award. Rachel Turner, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, First Textiles and Design and Gold Merit Award. Ella Turpin, Bronze Merit Award. Ruby Udali, Commitment to Star, Bronze Merit Award.
Well done, Ruby.
Dane Urban, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, Defence Forces STEM Award, First Software Design and Development, First Mathematics Extension 2, First Physics, and a Silver Merit Award. Well done. Louis Valente, Principal's Academic Excellence Award and the Bronze Merit Award. Victoria Valletta, Bronze Merit Award. Mark Van Ameyde, Bronze Merit Award. Jessica van der Heide. Sophie van Claveren, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, Bronze Merit Award. Alice Bigowska, First in Visual Arts, Bronze Merit Award. Kylie Vu. Peter Van Bakker. Eleanor Wallace, Contribution to Creative and Performing Arts and a Bronze Merit Award. Jade Walton. Callum Watts, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, Bronze Merit Award. Elise Watts, Bronze Merit Award. Emily Weber, Bronze Merit Award. Eva West, First German Beginners, Commitment to Star and Silver Merit Award. Zeke Whitfield, Mastering Award, Connecting Award, Gold Merit Award. Remy Williams, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, Commitment to Star and Bronze Merit Award. Riley Williams, Silver Merit Award. Emily Williamson, Silver Merit Award. Charlotte Wills, Commitment to Star, Gold Merit Award. James Wilson, Bronze Merit Award. Claudia Wolf. Scott Wong, Sports Person of the Year. Jordan Wood. Sunny Wood. Philippa Woollett, Bronze Merit Award. Tane Wright, Australian Olympic Changemaker Award and Bronze Merit Awards. Megan Zappier, Principal's Academic Excellence Award, first in Economics, first in Business Studies, first in Mathematics Advanced and Gold Merit Award. Okay. Congratulations to all of our graduating class of 2020. We now have our final musical performance. Please welcome to stage Hudson, Harry, Angus and Hugo performing Baby, I've Got You On My Mind.
Just what I can do, 'cause I think I know what you're going through. I hope you feel it the way I feel it. I hope you feel it the way I feel it too. Got you on my mind. I gotta show just what I can do, 'cause I think I know what you're going through. I hope you feel it the way I feel it. Hope you feel it the way I feel it too. Baby, I got you on my mind. I got you on my mind, girl. I got you. Gotta show just what I can do. Yeah, I gotta show just what I can do. 'Cause I think I know what you're going through. I hope you feel it the way I feel it. Hope you feel it the way I feel it too.
Great performance to finish the ceremony. Congratulations to all of the graduating class of 2020. It has been a truly humbling experience to be here and see all of your talents and successes celebrated. Angus and I have thoroughly enjoyed being your MCs for the ceremony and hope to have a great celebration with our year group next year.
The 20 Tiny Toombs and Max Donohoe have been great inspirations both here today and around the school. Max is a warm and natural leader who has the trust of all the school, and Tiny is a leader in every sense of the world. Together, they've been an awesome team and have been great models, role models for all of us.
Can we please invite the 2020 school captains, Talani and Max, to the stage to give their final address?
Good morning, Mr. Pickard, teachers, our virtual friends and family, and most importantly, the graduating class of 2020. We'd like to begin by thanking all of our supporters who have gone above and beyond to support us to ensure this year was as seamless and productive as possible. This includes our teachers, the office staff, and our families, who have provided us a strong foundation for our academic and social success here at Freshie. These last 2 years have certainly been unforgettable and have set us up for what is to follow. Firstly, we'd like to invite our motivational and wise year advisors, Mrs. Bayliss, Mr. Watkinson, and Mr. Lai to the stage. Mr. Lai. Thank you for keeping our spirits high throughout this journey by providing us with life lessons to use beyond school. We'd also like to invite Ms. Carney to the stage. Oh, firstly, Mr. Lai's back. We'd also like to invite Ms. Carney to the stage. To our dedicated leadership coordinator, who initially scared us with her intimidating death stares, but soon became the catalyst for action while entertaining us all with her wittiness and baking skills. Thanks, Ms. Carney, especially for the camel slice. Mr. Pickard. Thank you for creating an encouraging and supportive environment that fosters growth while allowing for personal and academic development. Mr. Mortimer, thank you for your dedication in ensuring that every single student is seen and heard. Mrs. Chowdhury, thank you for ensuring our leadership journey ran as smoothly as possible and encouraging us to seize every opportunity. To Chetty, despite the many TikToks, dancing and singing interventions, thanks for creating such a fun and entertaining learning environment in the library. And finally, to Caroline Powell, our school psychologist, who deserves our appreciation and gratitude for the much-needed support offered in these unpredictable times, constantly reminding us of the light at the end of the tunnel.
Just 2 years ago, we met each other for the very first time, nervously stepping outside of our comfort zones in an unfamiliar environment surrounded by strangers. We were certainly unaware of the friendships and memories we were yet to make. The decision to come to Freshie called on each of us to take a chance, to be willing to try something new with the hope of discovering more about ourselves and our peers. It was our mutual willingness and openness to try new things which sparked an inviting and welcoming culture that has been unique to our Freshie experience. And since that day, each of us has witnessed our own individual and collective growth, facing unpredictable challenges in 2020, yet emerging more connected and stronger than we ever thought possible. While COVID may have disrupted many of the traditional graduation events that we've been waiting a whole 13 years for, it definitely did not take away the lasting and irreplaceable memories we have made here over the past 2 years. There's no doubt we'll miss walking through the Freshie gates each morning, occasionally 5 minutes late with a Harley Davidson coffee in hand, or taking an extra 20 minutes just to be able to leave the school car park. Maybe we won't miss that one.
So what has made the 2020 Year 12 experience so unique? Never before has there been a Mia Colella, always up for a chat, keeping us up with the latest of Trisha Paytas and all other sorts of drama. Or Poppy, who never gave up on her vision of being in the shadow leadership team. Who can forget Jeff skating down the halls, or Megan and the Pitta twins constantly setting benchmarks for academic success. And Sunny, for always being there to remind us that Friday was getting closer. In so many ways, we are distinct in our individual personalities and connected through our shared experience, bound by a joint goal, but differentiated in our path to achieve that goal. These past 2 years have been possibly the most significant stage of our schooling that cannot be replicated. Fresh Year has provided us with a training ground for life, where we've been able to make mistakes, learn, and then make more, while always being supported along the way. By forming friendships and seeking advice from both teachers and fellow students along our journey, it has enabled us to evolve and grow while facing the mountain that is the HSC. All of this combined with the challenges of a global pandemic. This support has come from many areas in our lives, but most importantly, it's come from our teachers, who have done everything possible to ensure that our cohort wouldn't be disadvantaged or in any way held back throughout the year. With their often harsh, but always constructive criticism, preparing us to meet future challenges undaunted and with courage. Thank you to the wonderful Freshie teachers. We truly wouldn't have been able to do it without you.
To Mrs. Leonard and the STAR team, we would like to recognise your amazing work beyond the walls of Freshie. Thank you for your selfless dedication to our broader community through fundraising. Your work does not go unnoticed. And to the leadership team, we would like to personally thank you all for your support. The constant laughs and banter has made the past year so enjoyable and rewarding. I felt extremely proud to see the Breakfast Club vision come to life, an idea that began with our joint enthusiasm for mental health support. Your willingness to get involved and be engaged has made our school activities and commitments so enjoyable and successful. Additionally, with the help of Chetty in running Insta updates, we've contributed to the peak of Freshie's Instagram, massing a whopping 1,200 followers. Yeah, big deal. On behalf of the class of 2020, thank you for all the behind-the-scenes work you have all done.
And finally, to the graduating class of 2020. Talani and I have been so fortunate to have shared this journey with you all. So as we face our final days at Freshie, we are surely experiencing a strange mix of emotions. Jubilation at completing school, trepidation at the thought of what lies beyond, and sadness at leaving the secure and nurturing environment that has provided us with so much. The relationships that we've formed, the lessons that we've learned, the peaks we've celebrated, and the challenges we've overcome have all brought us to this moment. We challenge each of you to continue to grow and to never limit yourselves from all the opportunities that are presented.
And as we reflect on the year that has been 2020, we're reminded of the friendships that I'm certain will endure, unforgettable moments that are imprinted in memory, and the challenges we have dealt with that have made us stronger and more resilient. I think it's safe to say that no matter how many ways we divert in the coming years, we will never forget our time together here at Freshie. Finally, in the words of Oprah Winfrey, I've come to believe that each of us has a personal calling that's as unique as a fingerprint. And the best way to succeed is to discover what you love and then find a way to offer it to others, while also allowing the energy of the universe to lead you. So, to the graduating class of 2020, go out and be the very best version of yourself. Thank you.
Why do they always make me follow such excellent speakers? Congratulations, Year 12. It's been an amazing year. You've received an incredible amount of good advice today. Every speaker has given you a key message, which I hope that you take with you through the rest of your careers and rest of your lives. I have a few thank yous that I'd like to do today. First of all, could you join me in thanking Angus, Sarah, Demi, Emma and Karcher for their hosting of this event? Could you acknowledge the entertainment crew and the performers today? They've all been brilliant. Our band, who are all ex-students from the school, we're going to call you an ex-student now, Eliza, Dan, Andy, Sean and Eliza. Well done. Jazz Chowdhury and Kath Moran have put this all together. They deserve a big round of applause. There they are. There's one group I don't want you to forget today. That's your previous teachers in your previous schools. They've done an enormous amount of work with you. They set you up to be successful here at Freshwater, and they deserve your gratitude as well. So give them a round of applause. Parents, if you've hung on for over 2 hours and watched this live streaming, well done. It's a tough gig, but it's been great to share this with you. I hope that it's been, in some small way, you felt like you've been here. It's an interesting situation to be in now. Less than 2 years ago, the students and you sat in this very room, and I talked to you about high expectations, about buying into the school's culture, and trying to meet your new best friend for life. I trust that that's been the case with many of you in the room. I know you bought into our culture. I know you understood our high expectations from the get-go, and I think it was a shock to some of you. But the most important thing is I hope you've met some of your best friends for life. That'll carry you forward. Well done, class of 2020. I am so, so proud of you, and congratulations. All right. For the last time, would you please be upstanding, all the students? Thank you. Stand up. And for the last time in your lives, you are going to be dismissed for an assembly. Would you please leave the room? Out you go. Thank you, everybody.
If you don't want to see me, did a full 180, crazy, thinking about the way I was. Did the heartbreak change me? Maybe, but look at where I ended up. I'm all good already, so moved on, it's scary. I'm not where you left me at all. So, if you don't wanna see me dancing with somebody, if you wanna believe that anything could happen, don't show up. Don't come out, don't start caring about me now. Walk away, you know how. Don't stop caring about me now. Aren't you the guy who tried to hurt me with the word goodbye? Though it took some time to survive you, I'm better on the other side. I'm all good already, so moved on, it's scary. I'm not where you left me at all. So, if you don't wanna see me dancing with somebody, if you wanna believe that anything could stop me, don't show up, don't come out, don't stop caring about me now. Walk away, you know how. Don't stop caring about me now. Don't come out, 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 don't show up, So, if you don't wanna see me dancing with somebody, you wanna believe that anything could stop me, don't show.